Good morning, students. Now let us look at the concept of idea of development in the current context. And E.P. Schumacher's idea of development, or E.P. Schumacher's theory of economy, and Buddhist perspective of economy in this video. Idea of development in the current context. So what is the development in the current existing condition of the world? So in the present scenario, development means improvement in country's economic and social conditions. More specifically, it refers to improvements in way of managing an area's natural human resources in order to create wealth and improve people's living standards. This is the basic perspective and basic view of development in the current scenario. Certain seeds outlined several conditions. They outlined several aspects or conditions for the development. So they said the capacity to obtain physical necessities, particularly food, is one of the important objects of development. And the second point they outlined is job. Job necessarily not a paid employment, but to survive, for survival of the people are staying or studying, working in a farm or family or farm, or keeping in a house. And equality, that is another important objective of its own right. Participation in government is also another aspect of current development. Belonging to nation that is truly independent, both economically and politically. Adequate educational rights, especially literacy levels. Human scale development in the diversity, participatory democracy, empowerment of the people, enhancing basic human capabilities and basic abilities, and enhancing human freedom, and creating social benefits to all, and creating powerful economic interests of the nation, heterogeneous and diverse nature of civil society. The slogans like human-centered development or integrated development, human development, fundamental social, economic, political changes that are involved in the concept of development. So these are the basic points related to the term development in the current context. So E.P. Schumacher, another famous economist, he viewed economy not in terms of physical sciences, but he viewed economy as a spiritual science. So that is the reason why his theory became popular in the field of economy. So let us look at his object, his theory of economy, and also Buddhist perspective of economy. And since the publication of Adam Smith is generally considered the father of modern economics. He wrote a book, The Wealth of Nations, 1776, which is followed by the mainstream economists. And he says the mainstream economists of the world, they consider economics to be a value-free objective science, similar to the physical sciences. According to them, economics makes positive statements such as facts which are verifiable in principle. Based on definitions and assumptions, hypotheses are formulated, and statements are subjected to, and statements about the world, and these statements are subject to rigorous analysis based on logic, mathematics, and statistical techniques. Economic sciences has been developed increasingly in the direction of mathematical equations and statistical quantification of economic facts. So the mainstream economists, their economy is generally based on mathematical principles and statistical quantifications, and their economy is only based on the numbers and numerical figures. Schumacher argued against the myth of objectivity in the orthodox economy. According to Schumacher, unlike the physical sciences, economics is concerned with the human choices and actions, which by their very nature introduces value elements, numbers that are related to the economics. To be objective are often misleading to reference to human beings. Once meaning is attached to the numbers, then they are no longer numbers in reality. So numbers are numerical figures and quantifications actually are not given much significance and preference by Schumacher's theory. So here he also identified two problems with the industrial production and the materialism, theory of materialism. What is the problem with the industrial production? Especially the Western economy is based on industrial productions. Industrial expertise manufactures a large number of volumes or products at a low cost. Furthermore, these industries create decent employment to buy such certain products. The personal income has risen, and basic necessities such as food, clothing, shelter also were improved. So to maintain production, necessary infrastructure such as roads, transportation, electricity have also been developed. Western industrialization gets expanded. Unless there is an increase in industrial production, they will suffer either from stagnant or lower living standards. So Western countries have based their industrial production on various sources of energy such as oil, natural gas, nuclear, coal, etc. Schumacher, 1973, he examined the facts and figures about the growth of energy production, consumption, demand and supply, and found that industrial energy is predominantly based on non-renewable energy sources. Once these energy sources are consumed, they cannot be regenerated. So in the future, then people will suffer because of lack of these non-renewable energies, and people will have to adjust with the low living standards. That's the reason why Schumacher was against this principle, and he was also against theory of materialism. He said that there is a grave danger in theory of materialism. So materialism especially holds that the world is by its very nature material. The world consists of particles of atoms, matter. Each of particles are collected together for their existence. Materialism is based on the scientific investigations of natural phenomena and thus seeks explanations in terms of factors that can be verified. In the industrial system of production, materialism has been reduced to the ideology of market. It gives people what they want. The production, consumption, material goods and the acquisition of money are the major goals of the materialism. It is believed that generation of wealth will result in satisfaction with non-material goods such as justice, harmony, happiness, beauty and health. So against materialism, Schumacher believed in idealism. He gives much preference. He views economy as spiritual as prior to the materialism. For him, there was a higher, more real and more non-material world behind this existing material world. He believed that industrial production resulting environmental crisis. Schumacher marked a distinction between convergent and divergent problems, whereas convergent problems related to non-living aspects, divergent problems related to human issues. He thought that material philosophy of overproduction and overconsumption as a root problem of many problems that are being faced by the modern economies. He believed that material prosperity could not lead to world peace because it is attainable only by cultivating such drives of human nature, greed and envy, according to him, the man must never lose his sense of the marvelousness of the world around him or inside him. So this is V.P. Schumacher's idea of idealism. And the value of Buddhist economics is another important concept. Buddhist economics tries to maximize human satisfaction by the optimal usage of optimal pattern of consumption. In Buddhist economics, high standard of living depends on the minimizing the consumption, not on maximizing the consumption. Buddhist economics views the wasteful of the natural resources as a violent act against the environment and the society and the human living world. In Buddhist economics, work is essentially for the happiness and development of the each human being. It views unemployment as a great evil because it denies people's fulfillment of their potential. The Buddhist sees the essence of civilization not in multiplication of wants, but in the purification of human character. Thank you.